Hi everyone, this is Michael Eilbrock with Diesel Laptops. So this is the next part in the Diesel Tablet series. This will be part four, where I'm going to show you how to use the Save Sample feature. So I've already got my PID selected here, as you can see at the bottom. It's highlighted in red. I've got 5 PIDs selected. So I'm going to hit OK so I can see them. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the save sample and then compare sample. So I've already saved the sample as I was turning on the truck and starting it. So what we're going to do here is we're going to compare it while it's running to this baseline here. Okay, so I'm going to click on compare sample, and then it's going to ask me which one I want to bring up. So I'm going to click on number 2 sample running. And as you can see here, when I do that, it's comparing the standard range that I had with my truck while it was running compared to what it is at now. So if you notice on the left here of my actual data going on right now, it's saying there's something wrong with my coolant temperature because it's in red. But that isn't exactly the case, though. So this isn't a concrete good and bad feature. Okay, so how you have to use this is while you're going on a test drive, you can click on save sample for like on known good vehicles, known good operating parameters. And then you can save that, and then when you go drive another truck, you can save that in, while driving it under the same conditions, and then you can compare it. So it's actually kind of cool. I like this. That's pretty neat. It just stares out right at you, red, you know, like it's right there. So you're able to compare the data between the two, and then that can help you find issues faster. So it's another nice tool to make you more efficient. This is pretty awesome little tablet. I'm telling you. So so now that I've explained that, let's go to the report feature, and I'm going to click on report, and it's basically showing information of, you know, what you found before the repair, or a post repair, or it's you can also just say it's a diagnostic scan. So it's info for your customer. So in this case, this would be like pre-repair, I guess, and it's got all the info in here. It's a Peterbilt, it's a 587, it's a 2014, mileage, it's got the VIN, and then you can put your license here if you want. And then also what's cool, you can put notes in here. Okay, so I can, you know, say copied data file to compare performance issue. Okay, so we've got all the data put in here for the report. Now we're going to click on OK. And then the next thing, it's going to ask you, you know, put in your shop name, address, city, state, zip, telephone, email, tech name, customer name. You can either put in all this data, hit OK, or you can just do skip. I'm going to do skip. Now it's generating the report. And here's the report. So is the vehicle software. And then to extend it further out, you just click on this little check mark here, and then it shows all your data. So that's kind of cool. So you can take your data, your good data and your bad data, and you can show these reports to your customer, and you can show them after your test drive that you fix something. So you have proof that you fix something. It gives the customer peace of mind knowing that the truck is fixed properly. And it also gives the technicians and the shop owners peace of mind because then they have the paperwork to back themselves up in case someone comes in and says, "Hey, you didn't fix my truck," when in actuality, yes, we did fix your truck. We fixed a lot of things on your truck. So this is a good information system to have to back up your shop owner and your technicians, okay? And it's good for the customers as well, okay? So now let's go back here. So we've done record, report, graph, save sample, compare sample. We're all good there. So I guess the next part will be, which will be Part 5, I'll show you how to get into your graph files and play them back. Okay? So I'll see everybody in Part 5. Thank you.